know you've been talking a little bit and had some questions last time about our recruiting, and I certainly want to spend a little bit of time this morning talking about what I'm looking for in a candidate beyond what our amazing recruiting team talked about. But I want to back up just a little bit and not assume that even though I've been in Charlotte for 36 years and in CMS for 32, that anybody knows why I do what I do. And so I want to start there. I want to respond to your questions, and I want us to have a conversation this morning. But I do think it's important that it not be assumed or guessed or perceived why I do what I do. And so I want to start by, I'm not going to tell you my life history. I'm not going to run through my resume. But I am going to tell you a little bit about what drives me and why I'm so deeply committed to public education. And the first thing that I want you to know is that I grew up in a home where being an educator was affirmed at every single meal, on every single car trip that our family took, really every family reunion that I ever went to. And that is because my grandfather was a Presbyterian minister and a principal of the first school in a very rural county in Southwest Virginia. And my grandmother, his wife, was essentially a one-room schoolhouse teacher in the early 1900s. And they started the first school in that rural county that there had ever been in the early 1900s. Now, I never met my grandparents, but I grew up hearing about these two amazing individuals, a principal and a minister and an amazing teacher. And so deeply embedded in me is a belief that every child has a right to an education. And I grew up believing that education was the most noble profession that one could find. And I'm afraid, unlike many of our parents today, when their children start talking about being a teacher, that's not what our parents say back to their kids. They say things like, oh, you should think about something else. You're really good in science. You don't want to be a science teacher. Think about all the careers you can do. That's not the environment that I grew up in. I grew up believing that there was no greater calling than being a teacher. And that's important because what that brings is a belief in public education and great pride in being an educator and doing what I do with great people every day. The second thing you should know is that I have had an older brother who is no longer living, but who was severely and profoundly handicapped. And guess what? I became a special education teacher. But that really isn't the important connection to my older brother. The important connection is that I come at this with the belief in the human potential of every single person. Because I saw someone who was severely and profoundly handicapped do things no one believed he would do. So when we say in Charlotte, every child, every day, for a better tomorrow, that is the lens with which I look at all the data that you know and see and read about and hear about in the paper, both locally and nationally. I come at it believing in every kid. My lens is every kid, one child at a time. Not every male or female student. Not by race, big aggregate numbers. So when we talk about 85.1 graduation rate, I immediately go to a school and a list of students who did and didn't graduate. So I want you to understand those two things about me, because what they at the end of the day come together to make is a person who has huge pride in CMS. because being affirmed as an educator and believing in it as a kid at a time, that's where I come to the work. And so these pins, which I'm delighted to see so many people in this room wearing, means you're a part of Team CMS. Doesn't mean you work for CMS, but in essence, you're a part of what I call Team CMS. And so what you have standing in front of you is somebody who believes deeply in public education, deeply in the potential of individual children, and with deep pride, particularly in the Charlotte-Mecklenburg schools. And I see a lot of people in this room who I have worked shoulder to shoulder with. I see some every child, children in this room who were students when I was in middle school or a high school principal. And I think they will tell you, and I'm not their spokesperson, that that's who I am. I believe in public education. I believe in the potential of every kid. And I love CMS. So that's a little bit about who I am. Now, I know you got to hear a little bit from Rakita and David about our recruiting. And while they are the day-to-day face of our human resource department and the face that goes out along with many of our principals and others to recruit talent, at the end of the day, I know that I am tasked with what I believe are the most important hires in the district. And those hires are our principals. I believe deeply in the position of the principal. I was a principal at elementary, middle, and high. And I know that they are the key lever that's going to make the difference for every child. Now, at the end of the day, very few principals on a regular basis teach. But I know that a principal determines who comes, who stays, and who goes at a school, and particularly our classroom teachers. Great principal, able to hire great teachers. Doesn't matter where that school is located. Let me say that again. It doesn't matter where that school is located. A great principal is able to attract the best talent. A great principal is able to keep that talent, knows how to create opportunities for those great teachers to keep them in the classroom or keep them at the schoolhouse. Great principal also doesn't like incompetence. It doesn't like seeing incompetence in front of our children. And so they're willing to take what shouldn't be courageous steps, but unfortunately are viewed as courageous steps, to remove people that shouldn't be in front of our children. So while you might have expected me to say the most important job in this district is the classroom teacher, and at the end of the day, that is the person that makes the greatest difference for our kids, but I believe it all hinges on a principal. And so I know when our chairperson, Mary McCray, was here last week, there was lots of conversation, a couple weeks ago, there was lots of conversation and question about what are we looking for. Well, it was important for us for you to hear directly from the people that are the face of recruiting, but it's also important that you hear from me. And what I am looking for most is a match. A match of a principal and a school. While I won't run you through the entire process, there is a profile that is developed by the school leadership team that says these are the characteristics we believe are important for the next leader of our school. Not, we want everything that the last principal had, or we don't want anything the last principal had, but at this moment in time, these are the qualities that we're looking for our next principal. And at that point, it's the position is posted with that profile in mind, and that school leadership team advances a candidate to the superintendent. And at that point, the candidate has been very well vetted. So I have the luxury of knowing that background checks have been done, references have been checked. I may still do a few more reference checks myself outside of what's already been done. But when that candidate comes and sits in front of me, I'm looking for a match. And I'm looking for something that's very hard to quantify, but I believe 32 years have taught me how to tease it out. And that's something called belief. Because somebody can have an amazing resume, amazing educational credentials, have gone to the finest universities and colleges of ed in the nation. But at the end of the day, if that principal, that key lever, doesn't have what I call belief, they're not going to hire people with belief. They're not going to care about whether the people that are in their classrooms have belief. So when I say belief, what the heck does she mean by belief? I mean belief in the potential of every kid. Remember my older brother Blake? Didn't tell you his name. His name is Blake. I'm named after him. My parents knew that he was probably not going to survive. So my middle name is my brother. So I carry Blake with me every day. And the belief that it, in that potential of every kid. Now you might say, well, great if you've got belief, but if you can't execute on it, you've got a problem. And so that's the next piece. After I tease out a belief, and I want to find out how they're going to enter this school and what it is that they're going to be willing to do based on what they've seen, all the information that's available. Certainly the student achievement data, but also what I call the culture data. The culture data, the survey data, the student, parent, teacher survey data to give you a sense of what the climate's like in that school and how they're going to execute their belief and translate that into student achievement results. So that's a little bit about, I know a question that came up from the last meeting, and so I wanted to put that on the table. I want to certainly create an opportunity for you to ask more questions about that.